Hey guys, it's Carron. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, then again, my name is Carron and I make healthy lifestyle videos. So if you're not already a part of the family, click that subscribe button to stay updated on my future videos. And don't forget to click that notification button as well, so you'll be the first to know when I upload a new video. I don't have a set schedule yet. I'm trying to get on a set schedule, but for right now, they're most times on Wednesdays and Sundays. Again, I don't have a set schedule yet, but you want to make sure that you are notified when I do publish a video. So anyway, hey guys, I miss you guys. It's been a while since I did a sit down video. Most of my videos are like kind of pre-recorded. So this is like the first time that I'm like sitting down and recording a video in like a couple of weeks actually. So it feels good. It feels good to be back because the other videos that I did were my vlogs. If you have not watched that, I'll leave a link in the card somewhere. And of course, in the description box, be sure to check that out. But this video, as you can tell from the title of this video, I'm going to be sharing some clean, non-toxic foundations for women of color. I think it's super important, especially because this is February, this is Black History Month, so I could not end this month without doing something in relation to Black history. And as a woman of color, especially one who is into clean, non-toxic beauty, I know what a challenge it can be to find a foundation that matches your skin tone. And that's a question that I get a lot from women of color who are interested in using more non-toxic products, but they just don't know what's available or just don't think that there is anything available that is going to match their skin tone. I've done a lot of reviews of foundations in the past, so some of these are brands that you probably already heard of, especially if you watch my channel. But if not, these are some new brands, and hopefully you guys will find some information that's helpful. All the foundations that I am mentioning in this video, I will leave a link to them in the description box. And if I've already done a review of them, then I will also leave that in the description box so you can check that out. And if I have not done a review of any of these foundations, just leave me a comment and let me know, and I'll be sure to do that. So we're just going to jump right into it. My first one should probably be an obvious one, and this is from Plain Jane Beauty. I did a full review on my channel a few months back. I will leave that link in the description box again, but this is their Cream Minerals Foundation. This is one of my staples, my holy grail in foundations. The reason why I recommend Plain Jane Beauty, just because their shade range is like amazing. They were one of the first to offer so many shade ranges for everybody, not just for women of color, but for fair-skinned women, medium, light, dark, deep. Like, they have a shade ranges that matches everybody. I am the shade number 12, which is I Am Glorious. They have a cream mineral, which is like their liquid formulation, and they also have a powder foundation as well. So I am the shade number 12 in both the cream and the powder foundations. I wear them both pretty much, like I said, every day. They're like my staple products. I cannot say enough about it. The next one, and this is a recent review that I did. This is from the All Naturelle Cosmetics. This is their foundation. Now, they have the cream foundation formula, and they also have the semi-matte powder foundation. So, they did create a special color specifically for me. However, they have a good shade range, good enough to where I feel confident. They have like medium, deep, dark, lighter, fair. They have a good shade range, so I feel confident in recommending them because they have a good shade range, especially if you are a woman of color with deeper and darker skin tone. I feel confident that you can find something that matches your skin tone. And again, these are cruelty-free, vegan, gluten-free. All the brands that I'm mentioning here are, for the most part, as organic and non-toxic as possible. If not, then I'll make an adaptation of that. But yeah, with Au Naturel, they do make good products. I use their semi-matte powder foundation. I primarily use this more so than anything else, and I use this as like a finishing powder or standalone powder. I absolutely love this product. A little goes a long, long way. Like, this will last me for a while, but yeah, I love this stuff. The next one is from Coleman Howell. I have done a review of their liquid skin tint foundation on my channel before. I don't use their liquid skin tint foundation as much, but I am going to recommend that in this video because they do have some shade ranges that match deeper and darker skin tones. So that's why I'm bringing it up in this video. But with their liquid skin tint, it does have dimethicone in it. And I did mention that in my review for that. The reason why I don't highly recommend dimethicone because it can clog your pores. So this is definitely, in my opinion, not an everyday foundation. But it's good to kind of switch it up and change it every now and then. Again, I don't use their products all the time, but I do use them on an occasion. And when I do use them, I primarily use their cream concealer. This is their liquid cream concealer. I wear the shade number 10, which is just a shade lighter than my skin tone. I think the Clove and Hallow concealers are absolutely amazing. If you are trying to conceal dark under eyes or, you know, dark spots or blemishes on your face, I highly recommend these because it's more of like a matte formula. So when you apply it, like, it dries, and it dries really, really quickly, which means it's not gonna move around. You don't have to worry about it switching and moving around and going all over your face, especially if you have oily skin. I think it's amazing. I also use their pressed powder. I use their pressed powder, as you can see, like, I've already hit pan. Absolutely amazing. This one I wear the shade number 12, so it's a little bit deeper than the concealer, but again, with the concealers, I tend to go lighter and not darker as most people do. The next clean foundation that I'm recommending is Zuzu Luxe. I have not done a review of this foundation on my channel yet, but I can definitely do that. So leave me a comment and let me know if you want an exclusive review about this foundation. But this is the Zuzu Luxe. This is their oil-free foundation in here. And this is in the shade number, number 18. It kind of rubbed off, and I don't use this all the time, but I like this foundation as well. And now you can find it at Target as well. For the Zuzu Luxe, they have a good shade range as well. It goes to up to my super chocolate sisters all the way down to the like light bright. So they have a really good shade range. And again, this is oil free. This is cruelty free, non-toxic. The ingredients are pretty solid in there. And I believe this is gluten free as well. This is a mineral based. It comes in a liquid. I don't know if they have a powder formulation. I've never tried it. I primarily use like the liquid foundation, but this is pretty good. It's pretty lightweight. It's not heavy. And if you are an oily girl like me, this is not going to make you extra oily because, again, this is their oil-free formulation. So you don't have to worry about that. And it's also not like matte, so it's kind of like in between. It doesn't make you super oily and it doesn't make you super matte. I like it. I like to kind of switch up my foundations and not use the same things every day, so I use the Zuzu Luxe sometimes when I want to like switch up my foundation routine. The next one is Pacifica Beauty. This is their A-Light foundation. I have a review, exclusive review of this foundation on my channel. This one is fairly new. They've been out for the last, I want to say, like 2 years. And I recommend them because they have an amazing shade range. I think they have like about over 30 shades. So I would be surprised if you have a hard time finding a shade. I feel like companies are starting to realize that they need to offer more shades, and Pacifica is definitely one of those companies. You can find this at Target as well, and I believe it's like $15 or something like that, but it's definitely not more than $20, so it's pretty affordable. I don't use this foundation every day, and I think that I said this in my review, but basically this shade match is impeccable. Like, the shade match is absolutely amazing, and I wear the number 6 in the wintertime and then the number 7, which is deeper, in the summertime because it tends to get, you know, darker in the summer. But the shade, like I said, the shade range is incredible. The only issue that I have with this is because I have oily, acne prone skin, this is not a matte foundation. It is definitely dewy, so I recommend this if you have normal to dry skin. This would be absolutely perfect for you. If you are an oily girl, you're gonna have to wear like a matte primer underneath and definitely like put some powder on top of this as well. But even still, like, it's just super, super oily. So unless you're going through a dry season or something like that, if you're an oily girl, this is going to be a bit of a challenge. I really hope they come with a more matte formulation in this foundation because, again, the shade range is It's amazing. It's just like spot on. You really don't even need to alter it. And with certain foundations, I still kind of find the need to kind of alter it and stuff like that. But this is just like amazing. And it's really high coverage as well. So if you're worried about like dark spots or blemishes or anything that you're trying to conceal or correct, this is really good to kind of cover up those areas. And you don't need like, I don't even need a concealer with this foundation. Like that's how good the coverage is. And you only need like one application because the coverage is just like amazing. The next one is Vapor Beauty. I also did a review of this on my channel as well. And I'm bringing this up next to the A-Light because this one is a serum formulation. So again, this one isn't for oily, acne-prone skin. You're going to definitely get that whole dewy thing with this. This is their Soft Focus Atmosphere Foundation. It's a great formulation. The ingredients are really clean. There's nothing wrong with the ingredients itself. It's just that it's more of a serum. So if you're oily, it's going to make you oily and dewy. So if you have like dry skin and you need a little bit of extra moisture with some coverage, maybe kind of use this as a BB cream. I think this is an amazing product. This one is the shade S155. The shade is absolutely perfect. They also have a cream concealer. I use their cream concealer more than I use the foundation just because the cream concealer is like a creamy base and it is a little bit more dewy, not as dewy as this, but that one works as well. So if you are like my shade or a little bit deeper, then this foundation shade would work for you. They also have, I think they have like 3 or 4 shades that are like deeper than this. So, and of course they have like shade that are lighter than me. So even if you're lighter or darker than me, they have a shade for you. This next one, I did a review of this as well on my channel, and this is from the Jane Iredell. This is their Beyond Matte Foundation. This is new. I think they've came out with this like in 2019, so it's pretty new. And this is their liquid foundation. I like this foundation. The ingredients are kind of like the clove and hallow. They're not as clean or they're not as bad. There's no parabens or fragrances or synthetics or anything like that, but I believe this does have dimethicone in it, which again is another reason why I don't primarily recommend this. And if I were to use this, it's definitely not every day because it's going to clog up your pores. Even though this is a matte foundation, matte formula, because of the dimethicone in there, it is going to eventually clog your pores. So I don't recommend wearing this every day, but I think this is a good option for special occasions or you want to switch things up, but definitely not every day. However, and this one is the shade number 14, and it goes up to, I want to say up to 16. If I'm wrong, I'll leave an annotation. But yeah, they have a pretty good shade range, so this is another option if you're looking for foundation. And these are last but certainly not least. And I don't have the actual bottle because I'm sampling these out, and I probably will do an exclusive video for these foundations or for these cosmetic brands because I've gotten questions about it. And this one, this is like the sample sizes. I'm sorry, this is so ghetto. But this is the sample sizes that I got. This one is from Law of Nature Cosmetics. This is a Black-owned beauty brand. I have met the owner, Jasmine, several times. She's such a sweet person. So she did send me some samples that I am currently testing out. And she sent me the Walnut, Maple, and Nutmeg. And so far I've used like the Nutmeg. It has like more of a red undertone. This isn't a review for the foundation, but I did want to bring it up because number one, it is Black owned and it's Black History Month, so woo, it's Black owned. But they have right, they have shades obviously, and I believe they have, this is their powder formulation, and they also have a cream. Their cream formulation has, I believe it has shea butter and coconut oil in it, which again, I sound like a broken record, but y'all know I have oily skin, so that's a no for me. But their powder formulation does not have those oils and butters in it. So I think I'm going to order one of the powder foundations once I decide like what I feel like my true best match is. But yeah, I definitely do want to do a exclusive review on that. So give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment, let me know if you want me to do an exclusive review on the Law of Nature Cosmetics. Even if you don't comment or leave a thumbs up, I'm still going to do it anyway eventually. So. And the next one, again, I have like the sample sizes up here. I just want to like hold something up so you guys can see. But this is from Black Minerals, and this is their mineral. I don't think that they have a cream formula. I think it's just the powder, which again is fine for me. I found like, especially like if you have oily prone skin, powder is absolutely fine. I prefer that anyway. And they sent me actually a few shades. Right now I'm testing out Almond, but they have so many shades. Obviously, Black Minerals and Law of Nature Cosmetics, their primary focus is on specifically women of color, and it's a complete cosmetics line. So they have like eyeshadow, they have lipstick, they have, you know, they have like everything. It's not just foundation, but this video is primarily about foundation. So yeah, and I will also plan on doing an exclusive video about Black Minerals, but I could not do this video without bringing up those two brands. Even though I don't have the full size physical product with me, I still wanted to mention that, especially for my Black women, my sisters of women of color that are looking for natural, non-toxic cosmetics, like I recommend those as well. And Plain Jane Beauty is also Black owned. If I didn't mention that before, she's also Black owned. but even the other ones that I mentioned that are not exclusively Black owned, I brought them up in this video because they do make shade ranges for us, for women of color. So that is all the foundations that I wanted to bring to you guys. Again, I will leave all the foundations that I mentioned in this video, I will leave them in the description box as well with a link to the video if I have already done an exclusive review of these foundations. If you guys have any other foundations that I have not mentioned in this video, leave me a comment and let me know, because I'm always so interested in learning about other foundations and cosmetic companies that cater towards women of color, or at least have shade ranges and options for us. So if I have not mentioned something in this video, leave me a comment and let me know. Let's share. Let's share and help each other out. So yeah, so that was it. That's all I wanted to bring to you guys in this video. Again, if you have not subscribed, click that subscribe button. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you on the next one. You only give me the best. Yeah. You only give me the best that you have. Oh, say I just take it.